Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Wa salatu wa salamu ala Sayyidil Anbiya wal Mursaleen wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu kutiba alaykum as-siyamu kama kutiba ala alladhina min qablikum la'allakum tattaqoon. وقال عليه الصلاة والسلام من صام رمضان إيمانا واحتسابا غفر له ما تقدم من ذنبه أو كما قال عليه الصلاة والسلام. Dear brothers and sisters, the month of Ramadan is going on, and today is 13th day of Ramadan. Alhamdulillah, we have been able to fast in the day time and have been able to stand in the prayers in the night time, and also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala enabled us to perform other righteous and good deeds in this blessed month of Ramadan. Inshallah, there are some advices for all of us for the mid of Ramadan. Almost half of the month is over. We need to look at ourselves, what have we performed, and what are our preparations, what we are trying to get from the month of Ramadan. So inshallah, we will talk about these things. When we talk about the month of Ramadan, excellence, virtues, significance, we have been talking for the last several weeks, where we discussed that the month of Ramadan is a great month. It is a month of the glorious Quran. It is a month where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sends His special blessings to those people who are honoring and respecting the blessed month. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala frees His slaves from the hellfire. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives this opportunity to all in the Muslims, to mu'mineen, to reflect upon their life and do their preparations for the hereafter. So the month of Ramadan is a great month, is a noble month. The merits and the virtues cannot be counted. It is a season which is rich with gains for those people who partake in good deeds. They perform righteous actions in this month, and is a point to think for those people who are sinning or committing sins in the holy month of Ramadan. So this is regarding the virtues and significance of the month of Ramadan. The glorious Quran was revealed in it. There is a night which is better than 1,000 months, and performing any ibadah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in that night is better than whatever a person has performed in more than 1,000 months. So this is regarding the significance of the night that comes in the last 10 days as per the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Now my brothers and sisters, you might find two groups of people. One, they are honoring this holy month, fasting in the daytime, standing in the prayer in the night time, and performing other virtuous deeds. This is one group of people. The other group of people, that you will find them absent. You won't find them observing a fast. You won't see them in the prayers. And also, you might not expect any good deed from them in the holy month of Ramadan. Allah's Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam has mentioned in a hadith where he says that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, O my slave, there are only your deeds which I enumerate for you and upon which I will reward you. So whoever finds good reward therefrom, let him thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and whoever finds otherwise, let him blame no one but himself. So the month of Ramadan came as an opportunity for all of us. If we respected it, if we honored it, then we must thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And if we could not, then we should not blame the time, we should not blame other work, our works, we should not blame our businesses, but we should blame ourselves that it is we could not, you know, participate in the activities of the month of Ramadan. All of us know that days are passing, years and years are passing. The last Ramadan, maybe you might have seen some people were here, but you could not see them today in this month. Look at upon those qaideen, those leaders who were leading the last month of Ramadan, but they are no more in this worldly life. See many of your friends who were here in the last month of Ramadan, 1 year before, but you could not see them today. Many of your friends and other human beings, they were with you, but we don't see them today because it is the sunnah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That is the way that you come for a temporary life, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives you the joys of this worldly life, and He wants to see us that we are performing good deed or we are staying away from obeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and obeying His Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Death came and it overtook them, and it is sure that nobody can escape from death. When the time, appointed time comes, then you don't have any chance to repent to Allah or to turn to Islam. There is no chance. So before that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us this opportunity so that we should think about the reason, behind the revelation, behind the creation of all of us, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created us. In the Holy Quran, in Surah Al-Anbiya, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions, وَمَا جَعَلْنَا لِبَشَرٍ مِّن قَبْلِكَ الْخُلْدِ أَفَإِن مِتَّ فَهُمُ الْخَالِدُونَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is addressing the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he says that, وَمَا جَعَلْنَا لِبَشَرٍ مِّن قَبْلِكَ الْخُلْدِ. And we granted not to any human being immortality before you, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. أَفَإِن مِتَّ. So if you die, فَهُمُ الْخَالِدُونَ. Then would you think that they would live forever, or they are going to live forever? No. If you are dying, then everybody is going to die. كُلُّ نَفْسٍ ذَائِقَةُ الْمَوْتِ وَنَبْلُوكُمْ بِالشَّرِّ وَالْخَيْرِ فِتْنَةً وَإِلَيْنَا تُرْجَعُونَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that everyone will test the test of the death. وَنَبْلُوكُمْ, and we will send you trials. بِالشَّرِّ وَالْخَيْرِ فِتْنَةً, with evil and with good. So these evil or any good things which are happening to us in this worldly life, many times they are trials and tests from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He is trying to see us that how strong we are in our faith, in our belief. وَإِلَيْنَا تُرْجَعُونَ. And Allah says that to us you will be returned. So my brothers and sisters, this is a time where we can prepare ourselves. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has opened the doors of His mercy and of His favors for all of us. We need to seek those favors and blessings. And if we are successful in attaining those favors and blessings, inshallah, we will be successful in both the worlds. Also, there is a ayah in the glorious Quran in Surah Al-Jumu'ah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks, قُلْ إِنَّ الْمَوْتَ الَّذِي تَفِرُّونَ مِنْ فَإِنَّهُ مُلَاقِيكُمْ ثُمَّ تُرَدُّونَ إِلَىٰ عَالِمِ الْغَيْبِ وَالشَّهَادَةِ فَيُنَبِّئُكُمْ بِمَا كُنْتُمْ تَعْمَلُونَ. Tell them, O Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, tell them that verily the maut, death, الَّذِي تَفِرُّونَ مِنْهُ, that you are fleeing away from that, فَإِنَّهُ مُلَاقِيكُمْ, surely it is going to meet you, ثُمَّ تُرَدُّونَ, then you will be sent back, إِلَىٰ عَالِمِ الْغَيْبِ, to the all-knower of the ghaib, of the unseen, was shahada, and the seen. فَيُنَبِّئُكُمْ بِمَا كُنْتُمْ تَعْمَلُونَ. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will inform you. He will inform you. He will tell you what you used to perform in this worldly life. So my brothers and sisters, this is a reminder. This is a call for those people who are negligent, who are neglecting the commandments of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who are neglecting the favors that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is bestowing upon human beings. When we look at the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and this is one of the famous hadith which talks about the virtues or significance of the month of Ramadan, that one time the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam ascended the pulpit, the minbar, And he said, Ameen. He was asked, the Sahaba asked him, O Messenger of Allah, you ascended the pulpit and you said, Ameen. He answered that Jibreel alayhi salatu wasalam came to me and he said, whoever lived to witness Ramadan and yet was not forgiven his sins and as a result entered hell, may Allah keep him away from his mercy. Say Ameen. And I said, Ameen. So my brothers and sisters, we can see a huge warning in this very small hadith which the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is giving us, that Allah has given us this opportunity. If we could not snatch it, then we will be losers and we will regret. And that sorrow and grief and regret will not, you know, benefit us when the appointed time comes to us. So we need to understand the sanctity of the month of Ramadan. And we should observe it in a way that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam has taught us. Either it is our talking, our discussions, you know, our ears, our, you know, eyes, our heart, our brain, our, you know, hands, whatever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us. So we need to utilize or use those things in a proper manner that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam has taught us. Jabir ibn Abdullah al-Ansari radiallahu anhu said that when you fast, let your ears and tongue also fast. He said that when you fast, let your ears and your tongue also fast by keeping away from lying and forbidden things. He also mentioned that do not harm your neighbor. He also said, let tranquility and peace be your habit. He also said, let there be difference between your fasting and non-fasting days. So my brothers and sisters, see the words of wisdom, the words of hikmah, he is mentioning that our ears and tongue also should fast. What is the fast of our ears? That we should stay away from listening any bad things. We should stay away from listening to the backbiting. We should stay away from listening to anything which is against Islam, against the teachings of Islam, against the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Our tongue should also fast. It should be busy with the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, with the recitation of the glorious Quran, with the tasbihat, with the adhkar, and with whatever praises you can, you know, glorify to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So that will be the fast of your tongue. Also, importantly, he is talking about do not harm your neighbors. Your neighbors, who are your neighbors? The person who lives besides your house, that's your neighbor? No, your neighbor is the one who lives besides your house. Your neighbor is the one who is sitting with you for a few moments. Your neighbor is the one who is traveling with you. Your neighbor is the one who is with you, you know, in a meeting. So all these people are considered as your neighbors. Do not harm your neighbors. Tranquility and peace, he is especially talking about tranquility and peace. So we need to understand that how we should bring tranquility and peace in our life, and especially in the month of Ramadan. And he says that make it your habit. If you make it your habit, then inshallah those two things, you know, you will have in the month of Ramadan too. There should be a difference between your fasting and non-fasting days. Then we should compare our fasting days with those days we did not fast before the month of Ramadan, for example. What is the difference between both the days? So we need to find out and then thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. My brothers and sisters, we know everything and all these verses which I quoted from the glorious Quran. But still, why don't we see many of our brothers and sisters that they are not present with other brothers and sisters at the time of breaking fast? Why don't we see many other people that they are missing the Salat al-Taraweeh? Why don't we see that people are not attending the Salat? Why don't we see that, you know, where are, you know, all those people who were here last year, but we don't see them this year? The same thing is going to happen with all of us, my brothers and sisters. Maybe next year we won't get that chance that we fast in the month of Ramadan or get the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So it means that it is an opportunity and we should snatch it and perform the righteous and good deeds, whatever we can perform. The special month for the month of Ramadan, the special thing for the month of Ramadan is the glorious Quran. It was revealed in the holy month. Jibreel alayhi salatu wasalam used to come and recite or review with the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in the month of Ramadan. So my brothers and sisters, how much time we are giving to that special thing that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us? That is the glorious Quran. Either the recitation of it, memorization, reviewing, or whatever. Allah's Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam through his ahadith and sayings has encouraged us that in the month of Ramadan, we should increase our recitation. We should memorize. And if we have memorized, then we should review it. Because he has given the example of the memorizers. He says that always review what you have memorized of the glorious Quran, for it escapes from people's heart faster than the cattle when it escapes with its tying rope. This is one example he is giving. The other example of the memorizer or the hafiz of the Quran he is giving is like a tied camel. If you keep checking it, that it is tied properly, you check it, then it will stay with you. And if you don't check it, then the tied camel will break its rope and run away. So this is the example of the glorious Quran. If you have memorized it or if you have read it, then you need to give more time so that you can, you know, make it stronger and make it firm in your heart. My brothers and sisters, we don't give that much time to the glorious Quran, and I'm not talking about the Huffaz, I'm talking in general. Every individual is responsible for himself. So how much time we are giving? Is it enough that we come to the masjid and listen to the imam or the hafiz in the Taraweeh prayer and that's it? Is it enough that you finish one Quran in the holy month, in the whole month of Ramadan, one time, let's say one juz every day, and that's it? And then after the month of Ramadan, you close the Quran and you are over? Is it enough that you recite few verses every day, or the translation of the glorious Quran or whatever? When we look at our forefathers, my brothers and sisters, they used to recite the glorious Quran, or they used to spend their maximum time in the recitation of the glorious Quran when they are fasting, and also in the night time standing in the prayers in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Abdullah ibn Idris, this is one of our ancestors, predecessors. He is mentioned about that the time he was about to die, his daughter was crying. And when he was asked, "My daughter, do not cry, for I have, about that." So he said to his daughter, "My daughter, do not cry, for I have recited the whole Quran in preparation for this very hour 4,000 times." So this is the level of our forefathers or their attachment with the glorious Quran that they used to give. Now what we do, we come to the mosque, sometimes we listen to the imam, and sometimes we open the glorious Quran behind the imam and try to do two things together. One is listening, and the other thing is the recitation of the glorious Quran, because we don't have time. My brothers and sisters, so this is how we can understand ourselves, that how busy we find ourselves, that we don't have time for this great book that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us as a miracle, for all of us. My brothers and sisters, in the month of Ramadan, there is a moment every day that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is freeing his slaves from the hellfire. And Allah's Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam has talked about that, where he said that that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, at every time of breaking the fast, he frees from of his slaves from the hellfire. So this is also one of the time. That's why you can look at that scene that happens every day at the time of breaking your fast, that you come, sit together, dates and water is ready, and when the muadhin calls adhan, then you break your fast. So that's the time that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept our du'as, and he rewards us immensely, and also he frees his slaves. One of the important things that I would like to talk about today is i'tikaf, which is performed, and this is wajib. In the last 10 days of the month of Ramadan, there are etiquettes, rules, and adab. We need to participate in that also. And my brothers and sisters, we should understand that that is also something special in the month of Ramadan. Leave everything behind yourself. and you are fully attached towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Try to do this practice. This was a practice of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He was always doing this i'tikaf in the last 10 days of the month of Ramadan. The soul of the month of Ramadan you can find while you are in the i'tikaf. Also you can, you know, correct yourself. You can work on yourself. All those things, bad things which we, you know, take from the shaitan. Hypocrisy, enmity, hatred, not liking others, fighting with other people. All those things we can correct, my brothers and sisters, at that time. And also, because the Laylatul Qadr in the last 10 days, so this is, there is also a chance that we get that night. And inshallah, if we perform ibadah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that will be counted, more than the worship that we have performed in, you know, 1,000 months. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept all our prayers, our fast, our charities, our good deeds which we are performing in the holy month of Ramadan. We have few request for dua. Manju Poli, she is very sick in a critical condition. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive her. Also brother Hamid Hassan, his relatives passed away. Three of his relatives passed away in Pakistan. Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. Sajida Khatun is also in ICU in New Delhi. Make dua for her shifa. Include in your duas all the brothers and sisters who are sick or who passed away. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give shifa ajila mustamirra daima qaima to all those people, brothers and sisters who are sick. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive all our brothers and sisters who passed away from this worldly life. Jazakumullahu khair. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. We have 5 minutes for sunnah.